Hey, everybody, I want to take a minute and thank you for your support of our show. We've had a great past couple of months on the Chad Prather Show and Humor Me on Blaze TV. This isn't a hard sell, but if you haven't checked out the Blaze TV yet, you really need to. This is the only network out there that's consistently giving a platform to people who fight for what's right without being just humorless sticks in the mud. Again, it's not a hard sell, but if you're looking for a way to grow this network's reach and give conservatives a bigger voice and platform than what we've come to expect from the mainstream media, this is how it's done. So we've set up a code for fans of this show to use whenever you sign up. Please go sign up. Just use code CPS. You're going to get a full year of Blaze TV for less than $8 a month. Come on, folks. If you like what we're doing here and you want to support it, go to blazetv.com right now. Sign up. Use code CPS. I love y'all. Party time, Mom. We are back right here, Studio 22. Thank you for tuning in, listening, watching, whether it's on YouTube, Facebook, or you're listening via the place where podcasts are distributed. What's your favorite place, Mark, to listen to a podcast? Do you listen to a lot of podcasts?
I don't listen to a ton. I've listened to them some in the past. I think on like road trips, they're really nice. But yeah, I mean, I always use Apple Podcast.
I go to Apple Podcast because I don't need to necessarily see it. I know everybody wants to see how handsome we are, and it's starting to get rough as we get older. Candice, Queen of the Ethiopians, are you a podcast person?
Definitely.
Yeah, you listen to a lot.
Exactly.
You just listen, or do you watch them?
I listen more so.
Yeah, I don't care anything really about watching them. I don't need to see Ben Shapiro or Joe Rogan.
Joe Rogan, yeah.
You like Rogan?
Yeah, I do like Rogan.
That's I listen to him on the plane. You know, because that's where I think about it. Because I can't listen to anything in the car because I got Party Foul Steve just talking, just yammering all the time.
That's probably where you need it the most, though.
Well, that's actually not true at all.
Let me tell you how true it is. We listen to like David Webb in the morning because I like Patriot Radio on XM. We'll listen to David Webb, and then we'll listen to Will Cow, who, by the way, is also a host on Blaze TV. Get blazetv.com/humor. And they'll get fired up, right? Well, Party Foul starts to get fired up, too. And rather than listening to the whole story they're telling, he starts barking back at them like, yeah, well, them fools ain't even. And I'm like, bro, let's hear the news.
They fire you up in the morning, though. It kind of pisses you off sometimes. You're like, idiots.
Oh, my gosh. He's tough to travel with. But you know what? He's good for me. He's good for me. Keeps me humble, keeps me straight, keeps me alive, keeps me safe.
Somebody's got to tuck you in.
Doesn't keep me sane, though. Well, it's a party time, Mom. Good to be back with everybody here. And sitting in the hot seat today, my buddy, Steve Helms. What's up, pal?
Hi, buddy. I was afraid to talk. I didn't want to be jabbering like Party Foul over there.
Well, you know what?
Is there a limit to how much I can say?
Or? You're limited to 13,000 words per podcast.
Wow.
All right. And Candice, Queen of the Ethiopians, has got the ticker over there. She's over there slinging back the abacus.
She's like a court reporter over there just counting counting words.
Yeah, could you read back 10:43 to me?
He's at 11:349 right now.
Choose your words carefully. You've been on this show before. Of course, you didn't do the video.
We didn't have TV back then.
Back then, yeah, we did audio only. I love it when people say, you know, the podcast, you're putting them out a lot, and we don't get to see them. So back when we were doing audio only, everybody wanted a video of it. Right. And now that we do video of it and we put it out four times a week, people are like, podcast stuff. It's too much. Like, we've been doing it for years.
Look, either you want to see us or you don't.
That's
Make
right.
up your mind.
You can close your eyes and listen. You can do what Candice does.
There you go. That's what 90% of my crowd does.
I know.
They close their eyes.
Yesterday's. When will this episode going to put it out tonight?
It's
a headline
tomorrow.
Episode. So,
tomorrow.
Or tomorrow. Okay. Mm-hmm. What day is it?
Today's
Tuesday.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's going to come out tomorrow. So if you're watching this, listen to it. It's Wednesday.
Yeah, it's
Let's
Wednesday.
Pretend like it's Wednesday. Anyway, that's my ignorance. Because I don't know what day it is. I'm still jet lagged.
No, you're right.
Anyway.
Because you were hammered last night.
Well, I drink a little.
Didn't we just talk about time stamping stuff yesterday?
I drink a little bit. Producer Steve over here. Don't tell everybody what's going on. I went to the baseball game Sunday. And like everybody does, if you go to a Texas Rangers baseball game, at the beginning you hear the song is, "Nowhere but Texas, where I'll be." And I'm like, why does Steve Helms' song always have to mess up my baseball?
Stop it. Did they win?
Oh. It was a great game.
Okay, all right.
They came back. They were losing 8-2, and I think they lost 9-7.
Well, there you go. See,
yeah. It caused a rain delay, man. Your song. How long have they been playing that song at the ballpark?
I think this is the 11th season, buddy.
Yeah, what do you get, like 88 cents a year for royalties?
Something like that, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's not a lot, but I get a BMI royalty check every quarter, and during baseball season, it'll say MLB on there.
Yeah, that's fun.
It's not a lot of money, but it's cool.
But it's opened a lot of doors for you.
Oh,
I mean,
tons.
You know everybody.
Sure, I don't know, you know, out of however many people show up to every home game, how many people are going to Spotify now or that have downloaded it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, it's a great avenue.
I like being on the video.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
It with Troy Aikman and
all those people, man. It's
all
cool.
Those folks, yeah. But
I was excited y'all did it.
You did that. Well, that was like the 10-year anniversary of that song?
Yeah, that was the 10-year anniversary.
Yeah, go get it. Pay for it. Download it. Get it. You'll like it.
Please.
Unless you live in South Texas, then you're just going to about it because everybody's like, you don't talk enough about Houston.
Oh, my God. I got reamed for that. Well, you didn't say anything about the Astros. I live in Fort Worth, Texas. No, I didn't talk about the Astros. I don't care about the Astros.
I'm a
Texas Rangers fan.
They're like, Texas is a bigger state than just Dallas-Fort Worth. And I'm like, well, it would need 14 verses to the song.
I'm sorry.
And it's hard to care about a team that's 10 games up on the Rangers, you know?
Well, it just...
this time around.
But the funny thing is I recorded that 12 years ago. And back then... where was Houston Astros at that
point?
Exactly. They were at 43 games out of first place.
In the National League.
Yes.
That's because they were recruiting elderly people to play on their team.
But, yeah, I got reamed over that when we redid and put the video with it. There was a lot of hate.
I know there was.
You didn't say anything about Amarillo or Wichita Falls. Or good God. You know how many towns are in Texas?
You didn't say anything about Peaster.
No kidding. It's a six-hour song. Here we go. I'm just going to start naming off towns.
I've been everywhere, man.
Yes.
I've been everywhere.
Yes.
That's funny stuff.
And the bad part about it is it was my mom saying all that stuff. You didn't say anything about Cleburne.
He didn't mention Cleburne.
I'm sorry, Mom.
Oh, man. So Steve and I played. We've been around. We've messed around with each other for a long, long time, platonically and sexually.
Yes.
And being a good buddy of mine. It's Pride Month, so I'm happy to have you here.
Thanks, man.
So we can celebrate
we
our relationship
properly. We
should have
put our flag properly. Up, man. Yeah. Where's our flag?
We should put a rainbow flag up in here.
I love it.
Yeah, let's. We need to celebrate this thing.
I like waking up knowing that all my options are open. You know what I'm saying?
Golly, come on out with it, son. I'm out. I'm proud. Man, anyway, so what were we talking about? Oh, our romance. Steve, for those of you who missed the last episode we did with Steve, let me just fill y'all in a little bit on Steve. So Steve comes, Daddy Leon Helms, phenomenal musician as well, and Steve took up the family legacy and kept on doing it, made a little something out of himself. But what I want y'all to know is Steve is the fastest golfer on the planet. A round of golf should take like 4 hours, right? First time I ever played golf with Steve, 2 hours, 15 minutes, we were done.
We were the only people on the golf course in Cleburne, Texas. Stop it. It don't take 4 hours to play a round of golf if you're the only ones on the golf course.
Steve would run up on the green, putt, get it close to the hole, pick up his ball, and run to the golf cart. Where you at, man? Come on.
You're so full of crap.
It's true, bro. You still playing a lot?
I played yesterday. Yeah, I played a Whitestone.
Hey, did I tell you about William Clark Green the other night at
no.
the game? Okay, so we were all, Graham Allen and I, Sarah Gonzalez, and all of our kids and spouses and everybody were at the Rangers game 2 weeks ago. And we're sitting down, section 37, I think it was. We're about halfway up. And that's line drive territory right there. That's foul ball territory right down first base
line.
Yeah,
like head high.
Yeah. And so, ding, here comes one. I mean,
screaming.
It's sizzling, screaming.
Yeah.
And so over one section over. It's cruising into that section, right? And it's going to hit somebody. Well, all of a sudden, I see this hand go out, and it bounces off the hand, but it hits solid, right?
Right.
And I look, and I said, there's Will Green.
Was it really?
Him. And so anyway.
And he didn't catch it.
He didn't catch it, but he saved this little girl's life, and her daddy booed him.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So William Clark Green is a mutual friend of ours, is a great Texas musician. And so I looked over and I said, because I didn't know he was sitting over there.
Right.
I had no idea. He was out on a date or something. I don't know what he was doing. He had a friend there with him. And I looked over at him. I said, Will, you got to reel that in. He was like, oh. And so we had drinks after we went over to Texas Live and hung out. That Texas Live is a nice place.
It's awesome. I love it. I play there quite a bit, actually.
Yeah, you do over at Troy's?
Yeah. Normally it's the last Saturday of every month. And then I played the grand opening for Troy.
Yeah.
A couple months ago, I played his high school reunion.
Troy Aikman High School reunion.
Henrietta, Oklahoma.
Did he even go?
Oh, yeah, he was there, man. He put the party together.
That's awesome.
It was funny. There's like 30 people from Henrietta, Oklahoma.
That's funny.
Troy Aikman's class reunion.
That is funny. That's Troy's a good dude.
I love that guy.
You got a new single coming out.
It's out now. It's been out 2 weeks.
Really?
Friday Night Fever.
Been out that long? Well, yeah, I've been in Ireland, so
it's been
out
two. Yeah, about the time that you left to go to Ireland is probably when it hit through.
Yeah, what's it called again?
Friday Night Fever. Yeah, it's an old George Strait cut.
Yeah,
and his first CD his first album in 1981, I believe it was. That was one of the tracks on there. Dean Dillon wrote that.
Yeah, Dean Dillon wrote them all, didn't he?
Oh my God, yeah.
Isn't that crazy?
But I cut that one because you know, I did a "Can I Buy You a Country Song" CD. Yeah. With 90% of George's band, Ace and the whole band, were playing on that. And Benny MacArthur produced it, who's been with George for 35 years.
Yeah.
So I told Benny, hey, I got George's band in the studio. I wanted to at least do one George cut, but I wanted to do something older, you know. So I did Friday Night Fever, because we've always played that.
Yeah.
And but it went out to radio 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, I remember that song. Now that you mention it. Yeah. Attach George to it, I do remember that song.
It was cool for me to get to play with those guys. In fact, I think that's probably one of the last recordings that Mike Kennedy's probably on. His George's drummer that passed away in a car accident. Yeah,
we're going down. We're going to do Stormy Cooper has a studio down in Houston. That's you know, Stormy's the band leader for Roger Craigers,
right? Deal,
and good friend. And we're going to, Cooper Wade and I are going down. We're going to do some comedy stuff. But
is Stormy the one plays piano and accordion?
That's Huffman. That's Ron Huffman. He plays the bass.
Okay, yeah. I know who you're talking about. Yeah.
And but
Big dude. Looked like he could break you in half.
Never smiles. Yeah. Sweetheart of a guy.
He was in California with us when we went and did that trail ride not too long ago. Gotcha. Yeah. Because Craigor took his old band.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's
cool. So I got to see him then.
We did, he's going to record. Cooper Wade and I are going to do a live album next week, 2 weeks.
Right.
And down in New Braunfels, Texas. So get your tickets, come on out to that there in New Braunfels.
That's cool.
I'm
going to check my calendar. If I'm off, I'd like to come down there and hang out with y'all.
Come on. We're going to have a blast. We're going to have fun. We might even float the river the next day.
Now, that I don't want to see.
Yes, you do.
I don't want to see your white legs, man.
They're white, dude. Do you notice that the older you get, the skinnier your legs get? We just get emaciated.
Dude, my legs have been skinny since the third grade, dude. It don't matter how fat I get, my legs are still
I know, right?
People are
stand
like, dude,
up,
are you
Steve.
Riding a chicken?
Yeah. Stand up, party foul. No, I'm kidding. Don't stay down.
I ain't standing up.
Nobody wants to see that. Hey, Jennings, welcome to the show.
Hello.
You're on mute.
Thanks. There you go. Oh, thanks for having me.
Everybody now is wanting to see Jennings naked. That's fine.
Oh, nice.
We're getting messages every day. We love Jennings. Jennings needs to be on the show
more.
I have
said many times I'm totally willing to pose naked. You're just going to have to pay me a lot of money.
I want to put you in a Burt Rose on a tiger rug, cosmopolitan style.
Wait, I like that.
We have to pay you to see that? I don't see how that's fair to me.
Look, you're getting way more bang for your buck in terms of volume.
Yeah, two nipples for a dime. I mean, Jennings. Ooh, that's a faux pas. I don't see heat and naked either. So you get the songs out. Can I Buy You a Country Song? That's the name of the.
That's the name
whole
of the CD.
Album.
Yeah, that was the first single off the CD, but that's the CD title.
I just can see your sexiness right there against the jukebox on the album cover. That's
Thanks,
all
man.
I need to see. Yeah. You're good looking. Look at you.
Look at me.
Whew.
Photoshop's a cool thing, isn't it?
You know what I like? And I complimented you while I was in Ireland to my wife.
What's that?
We were talking about that pub crawl that we're doing in November together.
Right, yeah.
And we were going over there. Party Foul's going.
I can't wait.
You're going. A bunch of my guys are going over, and we're going to have a blast. Of course, we were just there. And so I was looking up the details on that pub crawl thing, and that picture of you standing there in the bar or whatever.
Right.
Good picture of you.
Look at that.
It's a good picture. So everybody knows that Steve and I are in a gay relationship, and we I don't know if everybody knows it.
Well, they do now.
But you and I know it.
Yeah.
And we send some very provocative things to one another, but we love each other, and that's all that matters, because love is love, and you can love anybody you want to love.
It doesn't matter.
That's right.
I'm just using you to get to Jade's all I'm doing.
I know. You got a freaking ploy going on. Oh, Lord help. She knows it, too.
I hope she's good, too, because I'm doing some really freaky things with you to try to get there.
She's well aware. I don't even think you got to try much harder. She's pretty open at this point.
I love Jade.
Oh, bless
her heart.
She's
so funny.
She puts up with some stuff, dude.
I made out with her once.
That's a fact. New Year's Eve.
I did hear about that, by the way.
New Year's Eve.
I did hear about that.
She wasn't willing, but he was. Do you know that Donald Trump has now sold 1 million Make America Great Again hats?
That sounds like a low number to me, actually. It does. I would think it would be more than that.
1 million sold at $25 a piece.
That's almost $25 million.
Yeah. That's
does that go to his campaign fund, or where does that money go? To his pocket, probably?
Yeah, no, I think it's a campaign fundraising thing. But you would think there'd be a lot more of them.
I would think that would be a low number, actually.
Yeah, I don't have one.
That shocks me. I figured they would have sent you one.
If you're gonna get persecuted if you wear it in public, why would you buy one? That's kind of became that the whole, you know.
Well, I mean, I love it because my friends like Brandon Tatum and David Harris Jr. They wear it everywhere they go. They sit on they want to get on the front row of the airplane, so everybody's got to pass them. But I mean, they're also giant black guys that nobody's gonna mess with. Right. And so, because I've asked David, I said, "Has anybody ever said anything negative to you about the hat on a plane?" He said, "No." I'm like, of course they haven't.
Would anybody say anything negative to them anywhere?
Anywhere.
Yeah.
No way.
They're huge.
Yeah, I mean, and Tatum played football for the University of Arizona. He's a hoss.
Yeah.
But no, I would think there would be more of those hats. Everybody in Ireland thought that my red Texas Rangers hat was.
Did they think
Trump
that
hat.
Was something like for
they thought
Trump?
It was a Trump hat, yeah.
Did they really?
And there's a T on it.
Oh, I got you.
And it was red. And so a ton of people, and I wore it.
It's
every day.
Red and has a T on it. So naturally, it that's Trump.
Everybody there was like, oh, Trump. Like, no, but whatever. How many days a week do you drink alcohol?
I didn't know this was an intervention.
Well, it's not. It's a confessional.
I have a drink every day, probably.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Party time.
I'm not saying that I have a fifth of whiskey or anything. In one day, but yeah.
So like I went.
Steph
to the
gets home from work, and we'll open a bottle of wine, or you know what I mean.
You're so elegant.
Yeah, I'm.
Can people
I'm fancy.
Get these necklaces on your website?
No, sir. I need to set that up. Yeah. In fact, we're working on putting a store together.
So our buddy,
I've been lazy about that, Chad.
I know.
Because when somebody buys something, that means I have to go down and ship it.
Can you see this? So this is your logo. It's been around, and I've got another one of these pendants, but I've got the silver one.
Right. We have silver, bronze, and brass.
He wears that one somewhere he can't show you.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't sound so judgmental.
Up my rear end. When I went for my colonoscopy, they were like, whoa, we have found gold. That's brass, to be exact. But you've had these things. Our buddy Justin Walker with Rocking Out Jewelry.
Yep. Rocking Out
makes
Jewelry.
These things. I want to get some made. See, if he get this whole deal done right here.
I still need to order mine for my other deal.
But no, I got Justin. He's a long time buddy, he's done some cool stuff.
Thanks for wearing that, by the way.
Yeah, man. Heck yeah. I'd have put the t-shirt on, but you know, I figured it'd be better washing my Mercedes using that t-shirt.
Thanks, man. Yeah.
Hey, toss me that. Ken DC, toss me that t-shirt right there. This is the t-shirt I love from Steve Helms. And if you're not watching on YouTube, you need to be. Only you can pull this off. Steve Helms, right? And it says,
Helms, yeah. And
I have to
give proper credit. We were on a golf course, I believe, one day, and Kyle Kerbel said that. I don't remember what we said, but he was like, well, Helms, yeah. And,
nice.
You know me, dude. I was like,
ding, ding, ding.
Oh, okay, brother, we can put that on a t-shirt. You know, and we did.
How many dates you playing out? I mean, you're a couple times a week, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, at one point, man, you know, that we were doing – back when you played five nights a week, dude, we were playing 250 days a year, you know. Yeah. And now it's, you know, Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. And then you do something like this on a Tuesday. I mean, there's always a radio thing. So if you really put it on paper, I'm probably doing 200-plus dates a year. But actual band shows, you know, 100, 150 maybe, you know.
Fort Worth is, I think, the music capital of Texas.
I think it is.
People think Austin, but I don't.
At one point, it probably was Austin. You know, you could go anywhere on 6th Street and see a cool band.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I'm about to piss people off. But
it's okay.
They want to be weird. Well, they've made it weird, you know?
Yeah.
Well, Fort Worth is not
weird.
Weird.
Yeah.
Fort Worth is a bunch of great singer-songwriters and guys that can play their instruments and pick guitars. And, you know what I mean? There's a ton of great players in Fort Worth right now.
Do you notice, though, with most Texas music and stuff like that as a genre, there's not a lot of keys in it, not a lot of piano? as compared to a lot of classical country
songs.
Yeah,
that's probably that's probably a true statement. There's probably not a lot of piano going on. There's a lot of guys that travel with a piano though.
Yeah.
I mean,
Bigger the band and
Pat's
the bigger
always
the deal.
Carried one and you know.
Roger, we mentioned Roger Craig earlier.
Randy's got a piano player.
Dude,
you know,
the bigger those guys get.
Stewart plays with Randy. He's played with Randy for a long time.
Yeah,
but you're right. There's more 4-piece bands, which means drums, bass, lead singer on acoustic, and a lead guitar player.
Yeah,
there's a lot of that. So that
And you played keys on Randy's album.
On Daryl.
Oh, Daryl. That's right, Daryl's.
But
it was the one that Randy sang.
It was one Randy sang on, and also the track that. Craiger sang on. I played some piano on that for Daryl. But I played piano on the road for Sonny Burgess for a couple years. Yeah. I'm not great at piano, but I can play a little bit, you know.
You're so humble.
Thanks, man.
I think that's one of the biggest things that turns me on.
Thanks, buddy.
The humility.
But the piano thing that you were talking about, it's probably a cost thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? When bands are getting started, you know, you're not making a lot of money, so it's hard to pay an extra guy to play an instrument. That's coming out of the money.
Yeah, that's
the
bigger.
Yeah, you know, so it's the guys that are making more money at shows that they can afford to have that fiddle player or the piano player or the steel guitar player.
Let me just really turn people on, okay?
All right.
Jennings can sing opera.
Nice.
Jennings can sing.
I've been known to sing in an opera or two, yes.
Awesome. Jennings got pipes over there.
That's cool. Now I picture really him in like the horn hat naked singing opera. That may be your niche, man.
That's, with a harp.
Seriously, man.
Yes.
Come on, Jennings, go to Ireland. You know what I'm going to do for Ireland? I'm gonna you know Buck Owens, Where Are You Tonight? Why Did You Leave Me Here?
The Hee Haw song.
Yeah, I'm going to turn that into an Irish.
Okay.
Irish ditty.
Yeah.
I think it would be easily translated. Where Are You Tonight?
I like it.
Why did you leave me here all alone?
Sounds like
I
a little Freddie
the world
Fender.
Over and thought I found true love. You found another and you were gone. What'd you say, Party Foul?
It sounded like a Freddie Fender accent.
Yeah, right. To the last teardrop falls.
Si que tiene Estela.
Oh my gosh. Hey, did you know that more than half of opioid abusers are also binge drinkers? That's what government data shows. How much money do they spend to sort that one out? That people on that are taking drugs, opioid abusers, are also binge drinkers.
It's probably a 10-year research.
That doesn't seem like a hard number to figure out, since 90% of the population of the world drinks.
Well, it significantly increases the risk of death from overdose when you drink with your opioids. So.
Right.
You know, it's one of those things that, and look, the opioid thing, like, I didn't realize how bad this opioid crisis, like, you hear about it, but do you really pay attention to it?
Right.
And here, several months ago, I was like, dang, this is...
Oh, it's a bad deal, dude.
It's bad.
It's a bad deal.
I mean, these people are just, I mean, and you feel sorry for them, because it's not like they're going out and doing it for recreational fun. They got hooked on it because of a pain or an injury or...
Yeah, it was a doctor-prescribed deal.
Doctor-prescribed thing, and then boom, it was over-prescribed or... Taking too many, and then they can't get off of them. And, man, that addiction's a crazy thing.
It's crazy, dude.
Like you and me.
This guy got paid to write you the prescription.
Yeah.
And you got hooked on the drugs. I mean, there's a whole thing there, dude. Yeah. I don't want to get into any of that. That's not my expertise. But it's a vicious circle, I think.
That's a bad deal. It's a bad deal. I've never had, like, you and I are addicted to food.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm about to take a bite out of this microphone right now.
You know, like every day you text me like, hey, take me to lunch.
Yeah. That's just because I want to see you, man.
Oh, yeah,
I just want to be around you.
Sure. Yeah.
No, it's because Chad always, he's like me. He likes fine dining.
I do like that.
When we go to breakfast, lunch, or dinner, it's some good food.
Dude. I know. Yeah. We do eat well.
We do.
He's like, let's go grab lunch. Okay. Let's go to Del Frisco's Double Eagle.
$500 later. We had a great lunch.
Man, the shave prime rib in here is a fantastic sandwich. $25.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. Well, and then also you're drinking Balvenie, and I'm drinking Irish Tullamore, whatever.
Anything that ends with tartar, you know, it's pretty good.
That's a fact. Speaking of which, where's my booze, Steve? You don't shoot a lot of guns and stuff, do you?
I own guns. I'm not a big hunter. I'm not.
Me either.
I grew up fishing.
Me too.
All my uncles and everybody, they were all bass tournament fishermen.
Yeah.
So I grew up doing that. But I own guns. I hunt, and I'll go bird hunting. My son and I go duck hunting. But
I'm a shooter.
But I don't have a deer lease, and I don't have the, you know.
I have, like, I have literally zero desire. And no, I don't care who does it.
Right.
But I have literally zero desire to go out and do any more of that.
Right.
You know, like I have guns and I love guns. Don't get me wrong. I love guns.
Yeah.
I'm a collector in that regard.
Right.
That could be an addiction. It's a very expensive one, but
right.
we like to shoot. And I grew up shooting birds and stuff like that. Not at the other driver, Steve, but, you know.
But I really want to shoot Steve the bird right now.
Like, I know there's this huge, this massive debate has been going on for a long time over the Second Amendment. And then Trump outlawed bump stocks, which we've talked about on this show. And now they're talking about a state-level fight over access to suppressors, as people call them, silencers.
Right.
And everybody's like, oh, you shouldn't, you know, there's no need to have something like that. Well, there's a reason for them, and I understand what you're saying, but the myth and the misconception, because this is the thing. So you had the shooting in Virginia 2 weeks ago. 12 people got killed. And so now Ralph Northam, who crazy governor over there, he called a special session of the state legislature to he wants to add more measures. And of course Trump said, yeah, we'll take a look at it. That gets into a slippery slope there.
I'm no gun expert, but the silencer, that doesn't alter the gun at all other than the noise, right?
It lowers. Okay, so.
Or does it change the bullet or whatever?
No, let's say you put a suppressor on. The idea people think, well, it's silencing it.
Right.
You know, you see a movie and.
Yeah, people are watching James Bond movies.
Yeah, which that's not what a suppressor does.
Right.
You still need ear protection to use a suppressor. So it's still louder than, say, a chainsaw.
Okay.
So let's say you're firing, you got a suppressor on a .45.
Right.
And yes, I do. If you got a suppressor on a .45, you shoot that thing, it's only going to drop it by about 30 decibels. So it's going to take it from like 170 down to 140 or 160 down to 130 decibels. It's still loud.
Right.
I mean, you're at rock concert level standing in front of the amps there.
I got you.
You're still jet engine loud. It's like if somebody took a phone book, a biggest phone book, slammed it down on the ground.
Right.
It doesn't silence anything. It suppresses it. So, you know, when you start banning these things, I'm telling you, it's a slippery slope, man. Slippery slope. That's why I'm getting that's why I love living in Texas. Nowhere but Texas.
Sing it.
That's where I'll be.
I get paid for that?
I sing it better than you.
I don't care if you sing it better than me or not. If I'm getting paid for it, just keep singing.
I don't do royalties.
Oh.
I'll let you sing it here in a minute. Or whatever you want to sing. You need to sing something to me, like a love song. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you know who Kylie Jenner is?
Yes. Unfortunately, I hate the fact that I said yes, but I do know who she is.
So, like I've always said, whenever you put on a dress, you look like her dad.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
If Caitlyn Jenner ever goes missing, we're going to put her picture on a bottle of Half and Half. I said that joke online a couple years ago, and people got pissed off. I still say my favorite joke, and I say this one over and over again, is that karate is just a Japanese word for my kid can't hit a curveball. That pissed a lot of people off, too. In China, what do they call their fine dishes?
I don't know, sir. I don't know.
What do the Chinese call their good plates? Yeah. You can't call it China.
That's like
this is the part of the show where Heaton slinks off and finds a hole to crawl into.
That's like the episode of Friends when they're going to China and Joey says, "Well, we could eat Chinese food." And Chandler's like, "Dude, I think there they just call it food." I think it's just food there.
What is it like over there, Candace? You have cartilage in your nose? Oh, my gosh.
That is so awful.
It's so awful. So the liberals are mad at Kylie Jenner because she's not taking a fictional online show seriously enough. This is the world we live in, buddy. They are in outrage and disbelief after Kylie Jenner posted a video of a birthday party themed after an online show that is widely seen as anti-conservative. And it's The Handmaid's Tale. You ever watch The Handmaid's Tale? Are you familiar at all with that?
I think I know what you're talking about. Everybody's wearing the
red things.
Dresses and the bonnets. And
is anybody in the studio watch Handmaid's Tale? No. It's okay, so what it is basically these handmaids are for birthing babies.
Gotcha.
So the rich, they have their wife or whatever, and, well, they don't want to, you know,
right,
have the baby themselves, so they they have sex with these handmaids, and then they're basically prostituting.
They employ
them.
Some other lady to pop the baby out for
exactly.
them.
Exactly. And then after they're done, after they get past their ability to bear children, they farm them out as like slaves to work, you know, manual labor jobs till they
gotcha.
Die. And they brutalize them. So anyway, so she did a Handmaid's Tale birthday party, which is really freaking weird, if you ask.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
But, I mean, consider the source, dude.
I know. I know. I want to see Caitlyn Jenner in the Handmaid's dress, in the bonnet. So they were mad because, a lot of people wear those costumes at the anti-Trump protests and stuff. And so Allie Maynard, who's a writer, she said, "I effing hate Kylie Jenner. She turned her mansion into Gilead from the Handmaid's Tale for her daughter's first birthday. She thinks it's funny. I want to scream, eat the rich." It's offensive. Wait,
did,
when people
did
are...
Did this person that's saying that, did they have tickets to Firefest, by the way? Because I think, wasn't she a big promoter of that, Kylie?
I don't know if she was or not.
I think she was. I think they was paid she... her like
I think she
a
was.
Ton of money
she
to
sure
advertise
was.
That.
She sure
was one
was.
Of the big, what do they call them?
One of the influencers.
Influencers, yeah. They paid her like $300,000 or something. Yeah.
That dude owes a lot of money back.
She'll never see it, dude.
No. He's still in prison.
He's still in prison.
Yeah, well. Who's the person said, "This is offensive when people are suffering every day without full access to reproductive care. Countless people are harmed by societal tendencies like those in The Handmaid's Tale. Jenner and her friends are using insane privilege to dip their toes in the waters of oppression."
So she was mad at Kylie for imitating the show, but she's not mad at the show for talking about it. And
well, I mean, the point of the show is women's rights.
Right,
and it's trying to be a. They're trying to, you know.
I get you.
Everything has to be a statement. It's all about women these days.
Oh
Steve.
My God! It's been, always been about women in my life.
In my life,
my mom ruled the roost. Mm-hmm. My wife rules the roost. It's my life's always been about.
I got
the women
a wife.
In my life.
I got three daughters. I got a mother and a mother-in-law. I got so much estrogen in my house that I'm in cycle with them.
See, there you go. Cool. You notice Steve's been real quiet back there.
Hey, you don't say nothing because he hears me say this crap all the time. Party foul.
I've heard it.
You know your mama's in charge of your life.
Sometimes she is.
Whatever.
Man, 50 years old. Mama's still ruling the roof.
Yeah.
Take care of my mama good, too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Ruling it. Jennings?
Oh, yeah. You better believe it.
Y'all don't understand, but it's Studio 22. You want to know who the boss is? That one's sitting right over there.
Candice,
the queen of the Ethiopians. She's in charge. You know who printed off this paper today? Candice. Told me what to say? Candice.
See there?
Who lets you sit here and breathe her air?
Candice.
Yeah. Her rarefied atmospheric presence.
I love it. I feel
it's
honored.
All about the women, son.
I feel honored.
But some woman did wrap her baby up in a plastic bag and dropped it in the woods in Forsyth County, Georgia. And somebody found the baby. Couldn't have been more than a few hours old, he said. Could have been younger. He said that he and his daughters had been unloading bags from their car at 10 p.m. on Thursday after coming home on a trip. And they heard the sound in the woods. At first, they thought it was an animal in distress. It wasn't until they followed the sound and realized it was a human baby.
Weren't you in Georgia about 9 months ago?
Nope. Wasn't me. We went down, pulled it up. There was a poor little baby wrapped in a plastic bag and called 911. She was alive and crying, so we figured it was a good sign. So, yeah.
I don't understand.
People are crazy, man.
Just when I get to the point where I feel like I'm on the fence about the death penalty, something like that happens.
See?
And I'm like,
we're going to get you out of that heat and stuff.
Yeah, right.
That heat and way of thinking. Hey, what did you pour in this glass?
TX whiskey.
Can I get some more of it?
Yeah, not enough of it.
It would knock the bottom out of that.
Oh, did you? What we got in here? So here's another one that makes it crazy, and I'm going to let you just sing a song or two, all right?
All right.
Procter & Gamble. They're pushing dictionaries to redefine the word black so it doesn't negatively impact black people.
What?
This is the greatest stuff I've ever... Procter & Gamble, man, they want them to redefine the word black. You see, you can't make this stuff up, right? Because this is, like I have said for 30 years, I'm like, you start redefining words... You redefine culture, you redefine authority, you redefine control. Like this gay pride stuff going on. Look, I love you, God bless you, parade, walk down the street, do whatever you want to do, wear your harness and all this stuff and your leash.
It has nothing to do with gay, though.
Huh?
That doesn't have anything to do with being gay. Shoving something up your butt ain't nothing to do with gay.
Look, here's the thing.
And,
look,
he thinks you protest too much.
So Steve and I talked. It ain't got nothing to do with my lifestyle when I put a sparkler in my butt. Have you ever seen those videos where those boys try to light the bottle rockets off and fire them out of their butthole?
Yeah.
And it doesn't go out. It's stuck in there.
End up in the burn unit at Harris Hospital.
It just flames their tanks.
Yeah.
Party time, Mom. Yeah. People are stupid, man. Listen, but no, that's and people keep getting mad at me. They're like, you're picking on gay people. I mean, whatever. I'm looking at your videos that you're posting.
Right.
Of these people walking down the street acting like fools. They were attacking cop cars and everything else in L.A. It's like, come on. And I'm not supposed to say anything about it. You're not talking about pride. You're not talking about equality. You're talking about control. And when you start defining language, don't worry about it. This won't reflect badly on you, Steve Helms. Gay people will still buy your records.
Oh, good.
Me and you will still be gay.
Okay.
Okay?
Good.
I love you. But you start redefining things, and you start, and then nobody can say anything back because it's so-called hate speech. This is the kind of stupid crap I'm talking about. Though it's My Black is Beautiful campaign for black women recently launched a hashtag redefine black petition on dosomething.org. Petition says the problem is words like dirty, wicked, and evil are offensive and derogatory and are still being used in the dictionary to define the word black. These words negatively impact the perception
of
black.
You cannot take the word wicked out of anything. The East Coast is going to freak out if they can't have wicked good eggs in the morning.
Boston.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it goes on to say that words matter. Yes, they do. So let's change the definition of black in all dictionaries and remove any negative definitions or associations. Somebody, their director of multicultural beauty, Procter & Gamble, said, we talked with some professors about the issue and the effect that words have on people. We started to wonder if this was something we could change. So here's Merriam-Webster's dictionary. An example of a phrase. His face was black with rage. Higher up in the definition for the adjective. I done went party foul, Steve. I done went full-blown party foul, Steve. Mm-hmm. Adjective.
Are you about to lose your dentures or you need to put them back in?
Hey. Fire Marshal Bill. Higher up in the definition for the adjective black than people's skin color or racial identity, its definition sections use predominantly negative words and phrases related to the adjective black as well. Dirty, soiled, sinister, evil, wicked. I can't even take no more of this stupid crap. Candice, sad, gloomy, but characterized by hostility.
We change definitions of words pertaining to black many times over when you're in relation to people. Because
I've never seen a black person.
Every generation calls it something else.
I've never seen a black person.
Well,
I've seen all colors of moths and
I should just say the same. You've never seen a white person.
I've never seen a white person. I see pink.
Look, that's white. Those letters are white. How many people do you see walking around that looks like that?
I was in Ireland and I thought a dude was powder the other day.
I'm not white. I don't even know what you would call that. What is that?
It pinkish.
Pinkish.
Your flesh tone. See, I can't say that because what's flesh color?
I don't know. It's whatever color you are.
Now we got to redefine the term flesh because, you know, it used to be you could talk about something. Did you see the thing? And I don't know if it's a parody or whatever, but the girl was all up in arms on Twitter because it said on her makeup thing, it said black, negro, and noir. And she said, it's offensive in the 21st century that they're still using words like negro on the color of the makeup.
Goodness. Let's change the Spanish language then.
This is so funny, man. It's so funny. Laugh at it, people. You learn to laugh at it. You got your buddies, but your butthole's in a pucker. You're in a wad.
It's so crazy.
People are crazy.
I am crazy. Negro with rage right now. This is ridiculous.
I am so noir.
Yes.
With anger.
Yes.
My face is flush noir.
But it's weird because when you say noir, then I think of Pinot. I think of what I go back to alcohol.
Cheers, my friend. Yeah. I know. Good Lord. Put the camera on Steve for a second. Let me. I gotta get something over here.
Why? Because I just wanted to take a drink. So you want to film this?
It's part time, Mom. Let me tell you, this stuff right here that Kevin Wade brought get you set back.
What's that, little buddy?
This single malt Miyagi-Yo.
Oh, that's Japanese scotch.
Yeah.
I've had that, son.
Miyagi-go. Hey! Bourbon wood finish.
So awful.
Well, it is.
That's amazing, though. I've had that.
Nico makes great whiskey. Miyagi-go. Single malt bourbon wood finish.
There's some friends of mine that their daughter-in-law is Japanese, and they and their son and her, they still live in Japan. So every time they go there, they know I'm a scotch freak.
Yeah.
So they bring me back that.
It's good stuff.
It's good. It's amazing.
I brought back some good stuff from Ireland. Everybody took it. It's all gone.
Speaking of that, did you just, like, go camp out in the Jameson plant, dude?
I didn't even go.
What?
I didn't even go. I camped out in other places.
So, okay, so then in November when we go, then we will go to Jameson.
Oh, I've been to the Jameson.
Definitely.
Plant,
okay.
But I didn't go this time.
I got you. Okay.
I didn't go this time. No, because I've been there. No, there's a place.
Since you're the ones that really keep that plant going.
Oh, we drink Jameson.
Oh,
that's
son.
Our stuff.
Yes.
I drink Irish whiskey, bro. But let me tell you, I found a new favorite, Yellow Spot. The Spot whiskeys.
Yeah.
They're hard. You can get them in America, but it's real hard. You got to look for them.
Yellow Spot.
I brought him back a little bottle of a Green Spot. But right. The Yellow Spot's, it's a 15 year.
Yeah.
Age. Whoo. Whoo.
Good stuff.
Honest good. But we drink, I drink Yellow Spot, and I like the black barrel, black cask, Jameson.
Nice.
So good. My favorite right now. But no, there's a place we're going to be hanging out at the Temple Bar or the Temple Hotel.
Yeah, Temple Bar Hotel.
And then Temple Bar is right there down the street across the street from it. There's a tasting room right next to Temple Bar.
Right.
And you can go in there and...
For these spot whiskeys.
They got everything.
Okay.
They got a lot of Jameson. What was it? It was like $1,800 bottle of Jameson in there.
Oh, wow.
I'd like to sip it. But you can go in there and they'll get you the little... things and you sip right. The different ones. They'll set you up on a little flight of stuff.
Right.
And let me tell you, bro, I spent $150 in there just tasting little things.
That's awesome.
Yeah, one of them was like, and I met some people from Boise, Idaho, and they were sampling stuff. And so I'd try some of what they had, and they'd try some of what I had.
Right.
Come out of there walking crooked. But this Nika whiskey, this Miyagi-Do, I'm about to wax on, wax off right here. Good stuff. You know my favorite song you do, and you don't ever do it, is your Fire and Rain, James Taylor cover.
I do it every show.
I like the way you do it.
What do you mean I don't ever do it?
I don't know.
Come to a show, fool.
I don't pay attention to you. Play me a song.
You want me to sing?
Yeah, I want to pretend. Y'all want to come and sit around here like Kumbaya and we're Jesus is talking to you?
Campfire. Right.
We're going to build a campfire set around here. Glenn Beck's going to be ticked off when we light it up.
Again, these chairs aren't designed
for
guitar
players.
Why do
you complain about things? I don't think you got to get that thing all that close to you. How's that sound, Mark? Good?
Hey, Steve-O,
yep.
Will you do me a favor?
Oh.
Will you get the capo out of that deal?
When you start asking Steve to do things.
Unless there's one back here somewhere. In the front, sweetheart, in the front.
Mm-hmm.
He wants me to do James Taylor. I need my capo.
You do anything you want to do, but
well,
I like
you
it.
You already brought it up now, fool.
I like it. I wish I could sing it.
There's a lot of people that wish you could sing, dude. If I get right here, can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Is that cool right here? Changes here. Sorry, man. I'm making your crew do work. Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. Walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. Just can't remember who to send it to. But I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Japanese whiskey. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. For my body's aching and my time is at hand. And I won't make it any other way. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time. My back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. But I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you one more time again. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around now. Thought I'd see you, thought I'd see you, fire and rain.
Clap, 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 clap. Attaboy. Way to represent. Look at you. So pretty.
You wanted to hear James Taylor.
I know. You're going to play something else. You ain't done. But before you do it, you give a shout out to everybody that shows your love, all the sponsors and everything.
Oh, my gosh. You put me on the spot now. I need that written down.
Your hat.
Resist All Hats.
Your boots.
Olathe Boots.
Uh-huh.
We've got
Rocking Out Jewelry. We talked Rocking Out with Justin Walker.
Got Antebellum Bags and Luggage.
Uh-huh.
Good Lord.
Your
Beards,
drink?
Beards Trailers.
Oh, you know what we didn't talk about?
What's that, sir?
Your beer.
We'll talk about that.
All right.
TX Whiskey.
Uh-huh.
Gotta love TX Whiskey. Legal Draft Brewery in Arlington, Texas. They make the Nowhere But Texas beer that's all over the state of Texas. Go get you some.
Mm-hmm.
Help put my kids through college.
Yeah.
Actually, my kids through college, so just put money in my pocket.
Right.
Who else? Let's see, because I'm forgetting them.
I know. It's hard, isn't it?
I know, buddy. You put me
that's
on the spot.
That's why I don't get sponsors anymore.
You put
American Hat Company. That's it.
You put right me here on the spot.
It's okay.
Now I feel bad.
They'll forgive
I know
you.
I'm forgetting one.
You did
one.
Most of them.
I know I'm forgetting one. That's awful.
Well, it happens when you get your age.
That ain't no lie.
Is the beer. You still rocking and rolling with the beer, huh?
Yeah, they're making it every day, man.
Yeah, it's good stuff. Pretty canned.
It's as far as I know, it's in HEB. It's in Total Wines, Central Market, Whole Foods, Costco, Specs,
mm-hmm.
and then, you know, restaurants and bars all over the state.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nowhere
Ballpark in Arlington's selling it. You can get it at Troy's at Texas Live.
Nowhere but Texas.
Yeah.
That tells you all about that beer.
Oh, yeah.
Can't get it in Alabama.
You can't. I wish you could.
Where can you get
I
it?
I wish
Nowhere
Alabamans
but Texas
were just drinking the crap out of it right now. But no, it's awesome. I'm very blessed to have that. They came to me with that idea.
Yeah.
I had nothing to do with that.
That's great.
They've been a sponsor of the band for a long time, but they approached mm-hmm. me with the idea of, hey, we want to put a beer out with your name on it.
Yeah.
I'm like, what? You know? And they said, well, Robert Earl Keen's got one. And I promise you, my response to them was, I'm not Robert Earl Keen. Robert Earl Keen could go anywhere in Texas and say, hey, I'm Robert Earl Keen. And people go, you're Robert Earl Keen.
Exactly.
You know? And I'm not that guy. But they're like, man, we believe in you. And
I know that
was
feeling.
That was actually the time that we were filming that video.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, here's what's going on with me right now. We're doing this video with Nowhere But Texas. And as soon as I said Nowhere But Texas, Greg, who we were having lunch that day, one of the owners, you could just see his eyes light up. He goes, dude, that's it.
Yeah.
Nowhere but Texas. That's the beer. Let's make that.
Yeah.
And they did.
Y'all need to get that video, too. I think it's been seen about 2 million times. You want to sing it?
I can.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for my good buddy Steve Helms singing Nowhere But Texas. Let's do this thing.
Let's do it. You going to sing with me?
Nope.
Blue bonnets, a yellow rose. Remember the Alamo, Chisholm Trail, Longhorn Steers, Lukenbach, Abilene, Texas Rangers and Judge Roy Bean, and ice cold Nowhere beer. Nowhere but Texas, that's where I'll be. It holds the answers to all my dreams. Well, I know one thing, when God calls me, Nowhere But Texas is where I'll be. We got cowboys, cowgirls too, Green Hall and Billy Bob's, Tex-Mex and barbecue, Robert Earl, Gary P. You can hear some Willie down on 6th Street. Nowhere but Texas, that's where I'll be. It holds the answers to all my dreams. Well, I know one thing, when God calls me, Nowhere but Texas is where I'll be. There's no way I'd ever leave. Everything I'll ever need's right here, right here. When I'm gone, you can bury me 6 foot deep in the heart of Nowhere But Texas. That's where I'll be. It holds the answers to all my dreams. I know one thing, when God calls me, Nowhere But Texas is where I'll be. Nowhere But Texas is where I'll be. Sorry I didn't name your city. Still didn't say anything about Cleburne, did we?
You didn't mention Burleson.
Golly. Sorry, I didn't mention Alvarado.
Nope.
What did you say earlier? Peaster.
Peaster, Texas. Prosper, Texas. Sweetwater.
Bacon, Texas.
What's that?
Bacon, Texas.
Speaking of places in Texas, guess where I'm going to be? I'm going to be in Stafford, Texas, Friday night. Get your tickets at watchchad.com.
Redneck Country Club?
No. We're going to. What's the name of the theater we're going to be at?
In Stafford.
And we're going
something center, Stafford Center.
Stafford Center. Stafford and we're going to be San Antonio on Saturday night.
Nice.
We're going to be in Huntsville, Texas on Father's Day, picking up hitchhikers.
Yeah, be careful.
I know. We're going to be in Huntsville at the Old Town Theater, Tobin Center in San Antonio. We're going to be at the Empire Theater. And then
San Antonio will be fun.
That'll be fun. Then we got to light that live recording. We're going to do a New Braunfels on the 29th, me and Cooper Wade at the downtown social. That's going to be a fun little event down there.
So nice.
We'll have fun.
When you're in San Antonio, go to the Rustic and have a Nowhere But Texas beer.
Did they open a Rustic down there? I didn't even know that.
There's Dallas, Houston, and San Antonio now.
I didn't know they had San Antonio.
Yeah.
That's cool. If I knew it, I forgot it. Steve Helms, get his record. Buy his T-shirt.
Please.
Get you a Helms, shirt. Where you got any big events coming up? I'm going to see. We're going to be down in the canyon in September, bro.
Yeah. Are you going with us on that?
Oh, yeah.
Nice. I'm glad.
I ain't missing none of them.
I guess the next cool big thing we got is our guitars and swim-up bars trip.
Yeah.
You can still sign up for that, by the way. Mexico.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's you do how many of those, 2 a year?
We did 2 a year, and now we're just doing 1. We're doing July.
Gotcha.
Guitarsandswimupbars.com.
Go to stevehelmsband.com.
Yes.
Follow him on Instagram and Twitter, too. He's sort of funny. @ Steve Helms Band.
sort of. I'm funny from the waist down.
Oh, merciful days. Yeah. I've never said that to you, sweetheart.
Thanks, man.
Steve Helms, support him every way you can. God knows I'm tired of buying his lunch. For Studio...
No, you're not.
The Studio 22 crew. Puppet Master Mark. Candice, the queen of the Ethiopians. Jennings and Party Foul Steve. For Steve Helms, I love y'all. God bless you. We'll talk to you next time.